All right, it's time for part two of this radio show, The Pigeon and the Partridge. Let's see what this is about.
The how and why of St. Pigeonations, question box. Hello, every birdie. This is Kawara Ryota from Class 2-3. It's time for the second round of the Question Corner. Independent programs like this don't have to worry about viewer numbers, so we can take it easy. It's very relaxing. Aren't you feeling relaxed? Anyway, this episode will be mostly spoiler-free as well. Spoilers for the BBL will probably start showing up in the second half. I think. At any rate, everyone can listen to this without worrying. Let's start looking at letters. This time there are three for me. First off, one from an anonymous individual. You look very good in girl's clothes, but how do you feel about cross-dressing? Is getting paid just an excuse? How do I feel? I'm not sure. I only ever cross-dress at work, after all. It would be sort of like if I worked at a convenience store and put on some sort of emotional weight into the act of wearing the apron, or something. It would be very strange. And as for it being an excuse, well, that seems odd too. It's just a normal part of life to me. On to the second letter. This is from one Ariko. I want to have Kulin be my personal maid.
Kulin?
Oh, yeah, of course, Kulin. I forgot about Kulin.
There is a time limit, but you can ask for me anytime you're at the cafe. I'll be waiting. And now the third, from Kulin Sexual. I wonder if that's the person who comes by every Friday. To Kulin, you're always so cute. What kind of clothes do you like? You can tell me, right? I'd like to see you in more than maid and Miko clothes, too. Like, maybe a sailor uniform? Haha. Come again soon, master. I don't usually do this outside of the cafe, but I had them get me a sailor uniform for this, so I'll be back in a minute. Oh my gosh.
Sailor Ryota.
I tried making bento. Will you eat with me? This is the first time I've worn a sailor uniform, actually. It's a little drafty for this time of year.
Oh man, he ripped that off quick.
The next one is for Dr. Iwamine. Let's see if I can get him in here.
What is it? Another stomach ache? Was last time's dose not enough? I do have something a little more powerful. With a 42% chance of painful death as a side effect, that is.
What? That's too much of a mortality rate. I'm not in enough of a hurry to play Russian roulette, you know. And don't go changing the background music like that.
But you have to, though, it's him.
This is the question corner, Doctor. There's a letter for you and me. May I read it to you?
What foolishness is... Very well. We shall discuss the compensation later, of course.
I probably don't want to know what you'll ask for. But thank you.
Okay, I'm ready.
It's from someone named Yuya, and was sent on December 6th. Ryota's birthday is the 3rd, right? Happy birthday! And the doctor's is the 12th, so happy birthday to him, too. Thank you, Yuya.
This person seems quite well informed.
May I ask you a favor? My birthday is the 7th. Could you celebrate for me? Just one congratulation from you would be better than Christmas and New Year's cards combined. Another December child. Happy birthday, Yuya. You should say something too, Doctor.
Why? It is merely another year in their life. What reason is there to celebrate?
Ah. Not that I had expected much from you anyway. I'm sorry, Yuya. I'll congratulate you for the doctor as well. Happy birthday!
Merry Christmas!
I feel like something else just got slipped in there. Anyway, happy birthday! I hope you have a good year.
If perhaps you have a change of heart and decide you would like to have your limbs and organs replaced, do let me know.
Don't even joke about that sort of thing, Doctor. Seeing as the doctor is here, I'll read a few more of these. This one is a question for the doctor from Just Pudding. Do you have a SECOM alarm in the infirmary?
SECOM? SECOM?
Do you, Doctor?
No, I do not make a habit of relying on such establishments. I simply do not leave anything in there which would be troubling to have stolen.
Use Gulgard. Easy and safe.
I think not, Mr. Gulgard. The doctor doesn't seem interested. And that's where I hide.
Pardon me, then. Please do call if you change your mind.
Ah, he left his business card even though we didn't ask for it. I don't have any use for it. What about you, Doctor?
Likewise.
Yeah, really. Time for the last one. This is from one helplessly in love. I am helplessly in love with round, adorable chew car partridges. Do all chew cars have the Doctor's suspiciously fluffy face? What do you think, Doctor?
A foolish question. I was visiting a town for the first time. The first man I met had a round face. Does everyone in that town have a round face? Or something like that.
It's from someone outside the school, so maybe you could answer less aggressively?
Aggressive? Whatever do you mean? I believe I answered in a clear and concise fashion. There is no species of bird without individual differences.
This is hard.
Hey!
I suppose the doctor is right. There are differences between individuals. Maybe the best way to see it would be to go to the avian zoo in Kakagawa or Kobe. Chukar partridge's eyes aren't completely round, so they do look a little bit lethargic, or maybe suspicious. Also, when they hold their heads out, their necks are surprisingly thin. They can look very vulnerable when they're taking dust baths, too. Do you take dust baths, Doctor?
What a quaint suggestion. Dust bathing is a behavior which arose as a way of removing parasites from the body. Our lifestyles have progressed such that we no longer come into contact with parasites, and so it is no longer needed.
You must do it every once in a while, then. A defenseless dust-bathing Dr. Iwamine. A fascinating idea, if only because of how hard it is to imagine. I think I'd like to see it.
Curiosity killed the cat.
Yes, I know.
Is that enough? I believe the material from last night's experiment will be ready soon, and I would very much like to go home.
Yes, we're done. Sorry for holding you up. Thank you. Why is every birdie so uncooperative? I hope I can have someone who'll play along next time. Then again, there are so many letters for the doctor. I'll have to bring him back on at some point. Maybe next time I should get him a present or something to butter him up beforehand. That's all, folks. Thank you for all the letters.
Amazing. Alright, that was part dos. Hopefully I'll see you for part three. Until then, see you later.